Forget that night out of the water. The way Graham smiled at me, starlight reflected in his blue eyes, nighttime breeze tousling his careless dark hair. The memory makes my heart flutter. All these years later, it's how I see him still. I'll forever see him. Deep down, we'd all known it a good while, but that night brought our fears out into the open. Parasite wasn't the quiet sanctuary of the past any longer. The shadow was spreading across the north, a ghastly chill we could feel in our bones. Our only shred of hope fell upon those adventurers still brave enough to seek the mountain pass. We needed them. And they, in turn, needed a kind face and a warm bed. I saw the sleepy dragon for what it was then, I suppose, for the first time in my life. A haven for heroes in their darkest hour. I found a renewed pride each time I put a log on the fire or a kettle on the stove. And with Graham at my side, I was certain that whatever lay ahead, I wouldn't be facing it alone. Fireside was changing, icing over. That year brought sheets of frozen rain like none we'd seen, certainly not in the summers of my youth. Under overcast skies, I clung to what graces had always given me comfort. The sturdy shoulder of a loyal husband. Friendships formed over decades of shared memories. Bonds that deepen in the rain. Once in a while, someone special comes into your life and changes everything you thought you knew about the world. Reaches into your heart and reveals unspoken truths about love and laughter and friendship and loss. Occasionally, that someone has 3 ears, 4 legs, and a tail. Thank you. seeing lights on in the old apothecary. It brought a certain warmth to my heart, but also a deep longing for the past. Skilled as Claire was, no tonic or potion exists that can restore the innocence of childhood.
Thank you.